Tell us about the differences between the
root
and the extra root and the dry.
So in the market you can find two different type of Prosecco, Prosecco Brut and Extra Dry. This is international classification. Unfortunately, you can't think in English because Extra Dry and Brut can make confusion. Anyway, it's quite easy to remember because Extra Dry is always has always a residual sugar higher than Brut. So with these two classifications, we indicate to our customers, our wine lovers, the residual sugar that the wine has. So Extra Dry always has a residual sugar higher than Brut. So for someone that likes to drink a drier wine, has to drink a Brut. For someone that loves to drink a little round the palate, the Extra Dry is the right one. You have to know that the traditional Prosecco in the past started to, as Extra Dry, and then in the with time we introduced the Brut. I speak in general, so the most of the wineries, Prosecco wineries, they started to produce Extra Dry. So the Extra Dry was and is the traditional method, the traditional Prosecco one, okay? Then, time by time, we introduced the Brut to compete more with the Champagne for people that love to drink a drier Prosecco. So we reduced the residual sugar and then we got the Brut. In our situation, the Brut has around, could be from 9 to 11 grams per liter. The Extra Dry from 14 to 18 grams per liter. Our Extra Dry has 16 grams per liter. 15.9 to be correct.
How do the different sugar levels happen in terms of your choices in the winery? What do you do differently for one wine or the other?
But actually, the base wine are the same. So the Brut and Extra Dry comes from the same base wine. Then there is a special formula. So we are the second fermentation starts because we add and we allow to.
Hold on, sorry.
No sound?
Yeah.